Good day, my friends. Froggy here. Welcome to Chris and mine's second ride to Clinton and stay at Caribou Lodge. A little different trip this weekend, a Sunday visit to Horstings Farm Market and the Log Cabin Pub. Heading up Sea to Sky Highway to Pemberton, we stop for lunch at the Sky Valley Golf Club. The driveway has metal animal art, ponds, and a great view of Mount Currie. An added bonus, they have designated motorcycle parking up front of the clubhouse. I was surprised to see so many bikes here. The restaurant is called Fescue's. Being a nice day, we hit the patio. All the bikes outside were one group having lunch. It was nice to know a few of them and share some stories. Fescue's is a great place, good food, service, with beautiful landscapes. It's a regular lunch stop when passing through this way. Leaving Big Sky, we head up 99, also known as Duffy Lake Road. Entering the Lillooet Mountain Range, it's uphill with switchbacks and twisties. Reaching the summit is a nice scenic ride through Cayouche Pass before hitting Duffy Lake. Duffy Lake is about 35 kilometers east of Pemberton, nearly midway to Lillooet. Its inflow and outflow is Cayouche Creek. It flows into Seton River, about 5 kilometers northeast of Lillooet, a contributor to the Fraser. This time of year, the creek runs quite fast and high, the reason why the lake looks silky rather than turquoise. The creek's rapids are awesome to see alongside the highway. Coming down from Cayouche Pass and Duffy Lake, the landscape changes, temperature gets warmer, entering the west southern interior. Just a few kilometers from the town of Lillooet is the foot of Seton Lake, naturally formed called a fjord, a long, deep, narrow body of water in a valley with steep walls of rock on either side. Seton Lake is about 22 kilometers long. We will stop at the Outlook for pictures, enjoy the view, skin down before carrying on to Clinton. After checking in, it's time for some evening supplies. Chris decides to stay and relax. I also wanted to check out Old School's Bar and Grill. Old School's is a themed throwback to biker enthusiasts without going overboard. When we visited last year, it was under new management. We'll see how it panned out.
They're closed. I can't believe it.
Yep, sure enough, closed. I asked a lady at the liquor store what happened to Old Schools. She said low business traffic. They couldn't keep the doors open, especially through winter. Hopefully they have a comeback. I just headed back to the lodge, parked the bike. Time to relax, enjoy some beers. The original Clinton Hotel was built in 1862, founded from the Caribou Gold Rush. Clinton was a center hub for travelers traveling between Vancouver and Prince George. The hotel became one of the most venerable and significant buildings in the BC interior. Surviving almost a century, the hotel caught fire, burning down May 1958. The Clinton Lodge was rebuilt as a rustic, classic log hotel we see today and very much enjoy the stay. Morning came, time to check out. We will head to Horstings Farm, just a few kilometers this side of Cache Creek, about 40 kilometers from Clinton. Chris's daughter Janine suggested stopping and check the place out. Horstings Farm is family owned and operated, spanning over 85 acres with over 20 different fruits and vegetables.
Kind of cool coming in here, eh? Horstings Farm. Just outside of Cache Creek.
Besides selling their fruits, vegetables, and plants, they have their own bakery with fresh daily breads, buns, cookies, and pies, to name a few. They also offer their own homemade canned goods from salsas to pickles, 20 varieties of jams made with BC berries. What they don't make, they brought in local, like dairy from Dairyland and free-run eggs from Chilliwack. Their greenhouse flowers and plants are absolutely vibrant and healthy. There is too much to mention. We did pick up a few things. With space being limited on a packed bike, some homemade fudge was a definite. If you haven't been to Horstings Farm, it's a must stop and visit. Just an awesome little market, I'd say. Leaving Horstings to the town of Cache Creek is only 3 kilometers. Cache Creek is a normal gas stop for me traveling through these parts. I will make it to Hope, 193 kilometers before topping up again. After fueling, we head west, Highway 1, the Trans-Canada. Spence's Bridge is just 50 kilometers and following the Thompson River. Spence's Bridge is where we will stop for lunch at the Log Cabin Pub. Just passing the driveway, I need to make a U-turn. The entrance is the same as the Bates Motel and pub signs, but more visual coming from the west. They open at noon. We are about 5 minutes early, so we will wait to have lunch. The Log Cabin Pub, for the most part, is well biker-themed, visited by many bikers. We meet some today traveling from Vancouver. It's a perfect model of what a roadside watering hole should be, especially during the hot summer climate this region offers. The pub was built in 1966, situated at the confluence of the Thompson and Nicola Rivers. The owners, John and Laurie Kingston, have operated it for the past 22 plus years. I do believe it's for sale now, if only I was younger. I may have invested. Our last leg is to Linton, Fraser Canyon to Hope, then home. Just outside of Spence's Bridge is my favorite spot on the Thompson called Frog Rock. Depending on time of year, it can almost be covered or totally exposed. Entering Linton's township is Main Street, also connecting to Highway 12 heading to Lillooet. I like to stop at the bridge and watch the Thompson enter the Fraser. The Thompson is the Fraser's largest tributary. When the Thompson water runs blue, it's amazing to see it mixing into the brown Fraser. We got a bonus view of a train passing under the bridge and a couple of hawks hovering overhead. It was another great weekend getaway. Thanks for watching. Be safe, ride safe, home safe.